everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to take our triangle congruence theorems a step further and learn what we can do next using CPCTC. You may be wondering what CPCTC stands for. Don't worry, I'll fill you in on the details soon enough. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to use CPCTC to state all congruent parts of two triangles. First, we'll learn what CPCTC means. Then, we'll complete an example problem. So, what does CPCTC stand for? Well, it's an acronym for corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Basically, if we have congruent triangles, then the corresponding parts of the two triangles are also congruent. Let's think back to a problem we saw in our previous lesson. We used the side angle side congruence theorem as the reason that these two triangles are congruent. That was the goal of our previous lesson, showing that the triangles were congruent. This lesson is about what we can do next. Once we've officially stated that our triangles are congruent to each other, then we can use CPCTC to say more. CPCTC allows us to state all other congruences within the two triangles that weren't already given to us, such as angles A and D being congruent, sides AC and DF being congruent, and finally, angles C and F. It may seem obvious that these parts are congruent, but you'll need to have a reason for everything when you learn how to do proofs. And CPCTC is our reason. There's a process we have to go through to be able to state all three corresponding angles and all three corresponding sides are congruent between two triangles. Step one is to use the three pieces of information that were given to state that the triangles are indeed congruent. You did this in the previous lesson, and these were the triangle congruence theorems that you could use for this step. Step two is to write a congruence statement, like this. You learned this in the previous lesson too. Now all that's left is step three. We can use CPCTC to state that all other corresponding angles or sides are congruent as well. There will always be a total of six congruences within the two triangles, three side congruences and three angle congruences. Let's go back to our example from earlier. We started with three pieces of information. Segment AB is congruent to segment DE. Angle B is congruent to angle E. And segment BC is congruent to segment EF. That was all we were given. But then we used the side angle side congruence theorem to say the triangles are congruent and write a congruence statement. Remember how it was super important to write the matching vertices in the same location? The reason is because I should be able to take away the triangles completely, and we should be able to write the other three side or angle congruences we didn't already have. So, using only the congruence statement, can you write the other three congruences between the two triangles? We already have two segment congruences written, so we only need one more. And we have one angle congruence given to us, so we still need to write two more. Fill these statements in on your own using the triangle congruence statement above. Pause the video while you do this. Let's check what you found for the third segment congruence first. We already had segment AB congruent to segment DE, and also BC and EF. But we were missing AC and DF, or CA and FD if you wrote them the other way around. And for the two missing angles, we could just match up the letters from each triangle. We already know that angles B and E are congruent, but we also have that angles C and F are congruent. because they're in the same location of each triangle statement. And lastly, we have that angles A and D are congruent. We now have all possible congruence statements written. These three were given to us in the original picture. Then, we wrote a triangle congruence statement because we had side angle side triangle congruence, and from there, we were allowed to use CPCTC, which is the fact that corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent, to make three more congruence statements. This way of taking things one step at a time will be very important in your upcoming proofs unit. For now, let's try an example problem similar to what you'll see in this lesson's practice game. This says, what congruency statement will CPCTC allow us to state about the triangles shown? Take a moment to read through the answer choices and figure out which is correct. Okay, let's go through these answer choices one at a time. The first says that triangle CGE is congruent to triangle DLM. Remember the process I showed you earlier? Well, this statement is created in step two, before we get to use CPCTC, so that cannot be the right answer. Next is part B. It says segment CG and DL are congruent. We were already told that just by looking at the markings on the picture. We didn't need CPCTC to state this. It was given to us. So this is also not our answer. Now let's talk about part C. This says that angles G and L are congruent. Well, this isn't something that was given to us in the picture. There were no congruent angle symbols in our picture at all. So we'd have to first show that the triangles are congruent using side-side-side congruence in this case, then write a congruent statement, and then use the fact that corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent to state that angles G and L are indeed congruent. So it looks like this is our answer. But let's double check that last answer choice just to make sure that we're correct. Part D says that angle C is congruent to angle M. Well, these aren't even corresponding angles. Angle C actually corresponds to angle D, so this is definitely not correct. Answer choice C is our final answer. Now you can use CPCTC to state parts that are congruent in two triangles. Remember that we only use CPCTC to state congruences that weren't already given to us in the picture, and we have to make sure the two triangles are actually congruent to each other first. All this new triangle knowledge is going to be so useful in upcoming units, so definitely make sure your understanding is strong before taking on that practice game. See you next time!